Today we are going to review the new NVIDIA RTX 3080 with benchmarks, and it is a very exciting launch because we saw some really impressive leaps in generational performance shown at their event, so it will be awesome to check that out in person. The new Ampere architecture is based on a new 8nm process node by Samsung, which is a big improvement over the 12nm TSMC process that was used for Turing GPUs. And there are many other improvements with the RT and Tensor cores too, which have really pushed the performance of these Ampere GPUs ahead. We weren't able to get very playable performance with the RTX 20 series cards with ray tracing enabled, but this time the story is going to be different. So let's get started with our ASUS TUF Gaming RTX 3080, which is actually a very good looking card with a completely metal shroud on front and a metal backplate on the opposite side, and I have also made an unboxing and installation video on this if you want to check that out. Our test setup today will be on a 9900K PC. Our 10900K arrived a bit late, so we just decided to use 9900K, but I will be building a very special PC with the RTX 3080 and the Core i9-10900K, so make sure that you are subscribed to the channel with the bell icon so you don't miss that. NVIDIA has also claimed that these cards perform up to twice as fast as the RTX 2080, but we only have an RTX 2080 Ti with us, so we are going to compare it with this, and it will be interesting to see how powerful this card is compared to the 42% more expensive Turing GPU. Starting with the Shadow of the Tomb Raider, we see the 3080 performing 31% faster than 2080 Ti at 1440p, while if we turn on RTX and DLSS, the difference increases to 38%. At 4K, we see a similar percentage difference of 34% with RTX off, and after turning on ray tracing with DLSS, the relative difference stays almost identical. Then in Battlefield 5, the 3080 performs 29% better than 2080 Ti at 1440p, and if we turn on RTX, the difference increases to 34%. Then at 4K, the 3080 shows an improvement of 37%, while with turning RTX on this resolution, the difference in performance reduces to 29%. Moving on to Call of Duty Modern Warfare, we see a 31% difference at 1440p, and turning on RTX here shows a higher difference of 38%. At 4K, without RTX on in this game, the 2080 Ti scores 25fps lower than the 3080, while turning RTX on this resolution shows a big difference of 43% in favor of 3080. Rainbow Six Siege is very easy on these GPUs, so we don't see a dramatic difference at 1440p, but at 4K, we do see the 3080 taking a lead of an impressive 35%. Borderlands 3 is our next title, and we see a 30fps increase with the 3080 at 1440p, but turning this game at 4K shows us the biggest difference of our test at 51%. Red Dead Redemption 2 is still not the most optimized game, and we see a 31% difference between these two cards at 1440p, and switching to 4K, we see a more dramatic improvement of 38% with the 3080. In Division 2 at 1440p, we see a relatively modest performance increase of 28% with the 3080, but this difference does increase to 38% at 4K. Finally, coming to our charts of averages, the 3080 shows the biggest performance increase over 2080 Ti at 4K at 39%, and this number did shift higher because of the 50% performance difference with the Borderlands 3. At 1440p ray tracing enabled, we see an increase of 37%, a similar 35% of difference when we keep it at 4K, and our non-RTX 1440p result shows the lowest difference of 28%. Then for some productivity benchmarks, we see a really huge difference in V-Ray benchmark, but in Adobe Premiere Pro, we only see a 7% difference. The VRAM on the 3080 is actually lower than 2080 Ti at 10GB versus 11GB on the Turing card, so it will be interesting to see how much of an improvement the 3090 may bring, because it has a whopping 24GB of VRAM. The total system power draw with the 3080 is higher than the 2080 Ti, which was already quite high, and so it is not a surprise that we have higher watt PSU recommendations for these cards, even though they are way more efficient than before. NVIDIA has also introduced some new technologies like NVIDIA Reflex with these cards, which reduces the system latency and allows you to measure the latency between your input and the action appearing in your games. And yes, NVIDIA Reflex sounds a lot like my channel's name Tech Reflex, so they did reach out to me to check if I was okay with them using this name, and I thought that they are making great GPUs and they are also taking the technology and the industry forward, so I told them that I was cool with it and they could use this name. Overall, the RTX 3080 offers a really good improvement at a seriously lower price point compared to the RTX 2080 Ti. It is 30% cheaper than the 2080 Ti, but it delivers an average performance increase of 35%. Now, I have seen some people being really fixated on whether the 3080 is able to deliver twice the performance of 2080 in all games or not, and while what Nvidia meant was up to 2 times performance compared to 2080, which they meant for games like Quake 2 RTX, what everyone heard was double the performance of 2080 without the up to part. And that oversight from both sides has led some people to think that the 3080 is underwhelming, but I really don't believe that that is the case, because we are getting a really impressive improvement at a much lower price. The Tuf Gaming edition of this 3080 specifically is also really amazing. I'll link to the review by Hardware Unboxed, and they have also praised how silent this GPU runs and how it can perform up to 6% faster than the Founders Edition while being 15 degrees cooler at almost identical price point. Our Tuf Gaming 3080 also ran at 61 degrees Celsius on Fermark stress test, but we didn't have a reference point for how cool that is. It also features a completely metal heatsink shroud along with a thick metal backplate, and it uses standard 8-pin PCIe connectors. So at its price point of 71,000 rupees in India and $700 internationally, it is really a no-brainer if you are looking for a no-nonsense card that is extremely well-built. It's also interesting to note how much ASUS has improved their products after receiving criticism from the media. After the reviewers criticized the VRMs on the Z390 series of motherboards, they went overboard with the X570 and had top-tier VRMs on their mid-range motherboards. And then after the media highlighted the issues with the previous GPUs in the Tuf family, they brought huge improvements to it with cards like this one. And I think that is why we are seeing the Tuf Gaming cards in the hands of the reviewers before the Strix cards, so that this will get the complete attention first and people will know how good they have gotten with this, and then they will introduce the Strix cards, which will get the usual attention. But interesting marketing and product improvement strategies aside, the RTX 3080 Tuf Gaming is a really great variant of a really great GPU release from Nvidia, and it is something that I can recommend very strongly. As long as you like the minimal aesthetics and don't want something more blingy and flashy like the Strix cards. And that was it for now. I'll have links to buy this card whenever it becomes available in the video description. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Let me know what you think about this card in the comment section below. Subscribe with bell icon for more RTX content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.